Hey everybody, it's Charlie from Daily Motor. Today we've got the sound system demo of the 2022 Volkswagen Golf GTI and its 9-speaker, 440-watt Harman Kardon audio system. This is going to be an in-depth review. We're going to take a look at how the infotainment system works, take a look at audio inputs and controls and adjustments, speaker locations, Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, then get out on the road and listen to these sample tracks while rolling. I'll give you my thoughts at the end. Now, if you don't care about any of that stuff at the beginning, you just want to listen to the music, click ahead in the video. We've got chapters to get you right to the tunes. Before we get started, let's hop out and take a look at this. Now, it should be noted, this is actually the European spec of the new Golf GTI. They don't have them here in America yet, but we were lucky enough to get our hands on a European model. We even got the German license plate up there. But this thing is looking cool. It's a hoot holler and a half to drive. So if you do want to see more on it, check the links in the description. Hopefully this Harman Kardon audio system packages the same once it comes here to America. I know it should be available in the SE trim and above. There's an S trim below with a lower sound system. I think that one will have 7 speakers or so. But for now, we're working with what we got, and all the functionality and operation should be very similar once we get the car here on our shores. Now, we always do these tests with lossless, uncompressed WAV audio files on a USB stick plugged directly into the system and high-quality Roland binaural microphones in both of my ears, giving you the most realistic audio system demo on YouTube. We also do the test with the sound settings set to their factory defaults, just as the audio engineers intended. So let's take a look at those now. The upper model infotainment system, I think this is 10.25 inches or so. In the US specs, you're not going to get this screen with the S trim, but I think SE and above, you should be getting this one. Let's take a look. Very similar to what we saw in the ID4 and some of the other new Volkswagen products. Let's go to sound. A lot going on in the sound menus here. So you've got, appears to be about a 9-band equalizer plus a subwoofer adjustment over here at the end. Now, I don't know why they didn't put a subwoofer adjustment on the low end of the equalizer down by bass, but they put it up here in the top, so you just gotta kinda know where that is. Looks like you can turn the equalizer on and off and just go to this pure chill out, live, or energy settings. So I think those are kind of pre-mixed equalizer settings. Let's go through those now. We're on pure right now. Go to chill out, live, listen to that difference there between energy and live. It is interesting that it's not actually making subwoofer adjustments, or not subwoofer, equalizer adjustments here when you select those different ones. So in theory, you could go to this one, the energy one, and then you could also mess with the equalizer. So let's go through and mess it up a little bit here. I guess I should let the music start a little bit more. You can see when you click this, it disables the EQ and it sounds much different. I really appreciate that they have a reset button, and I also just really appreciate having a multi-band equalizer in any car. I think all cars should have at least 5-band equalizers, so it's nice to see that here in the new GTI. You can also change the sound focus. You can focus it, you got your standard balance and fader there, but you can also go to sound focus here and click on one of the seats, so now it's just focused on the driver. Driver and passenger. Rear, front. So it's a few different ways to do that. And then there's a surround adjustment as well. So you can go all the way from stereo here. And then we'll work our way up to surround. That's neat to be able to play around with that as well. And then you also have a volume screen. It allows you to change the volume for, let's see, radio announcements, voice control, maximum switch-on volume. That's nice so your kids can't jack the volume all the way up and get out and you get in the car in the morning and it's on max volume. So a lot of adjustments. I really like that. It's a little bit overwhelming, but once you kind of get used to how to use it, it works quite well. Audio controls. You can see for a volume control, there's no knob. It's instead this little slider. I'm not a big fan of it, but it's definitely better than the haptic controls in, say, the new Hyundais that don't allow you to slide. At least you can slide your finger along and make rapid adjustments. I think that's important. Now, my finger's kind of sweaty right now. It sort of grips along there, but it still works. You can tap as well. You have a similar setup on the wheel. You can slide. Slide, maybe? You gotta slide a few times. But you can also just kind of click it. I'd still ultimately like to have a knob, but this is not the worst setup. For track selection, you are getting a little rough because there's no sort of control, physical control, or even haptic control outside of the touchscreen over here. And this is an issue in any vehicle. For example, the Buick Envision we had last week had the same sort of setup. No physical control or any control outside of the touchscreen for track selection over there. And I was using the navigation screen, which isn't going to load in this car because it's a Euro car. But I was using the navigation screen in the Envision, and my passenger was picky and wanted to change the radio station regularly. And each time we did that, we were on a road trip, so we had to go somewhere. Each time we did that, he had to go home and then go to media and make his adjustment in the radio. And then I had to go back to the navigation so I could see what our next turn was. So it's frustrating that you don't have any sort of adjustment here to change track rather than going to the media screen and then pulling over and clicking next. You do have a steering wheel adjustment, so yes, you can click through there. But again, if your passenger wants to make radio selections, then that doesn't help them. Audio inputs in the new GTI. You have your standard AM, FM, Sirius XM satellite radio, Bluetooth, wireless Apple CarPlay and Android Auto with a wireless device charger as well. So I like to see that. Two USB-C ports for data up there. That's nice to see as well. And that is it. So what does that mean you're missing? No disc player, no 3.5 millimeter auxiliary input jack. Now that's a mouthful. And no USB-A port. So make sure you're carrying around a Type-C to Type-A adapter. Speaker locations. Now, Volkswagen says this is a 9-speaker system, but if you include the subwoofer, I actually count 10. So let's take a look here. Start in the bottom left. 1, 2, 3 center speaker, 4, 5 in that door. Moving around to the back, we've got 6, 7, 8, 9 in that door. Then, you open up the trunk, and under here, instead of a spare tire, you've got a subwoofer. See if, probably not really even going to be able to hear it, but you can feel it's making bass, very subtle, and that's definitely a subwoofer. So it's interesting that they only call it a 9-speaker system. They don't count the subwoofer. You'd think they'd want to count it. So maybe once it launches here, there we go, you can hear it now. Very clearly a subwoofer, and obviously we had subwoofer adjustment on the infotainment screen as well, so it's strange that they don't count it in the overall speaker count. Apple CarPlay and Android Auto demonstrations. Let's start off with Android Auto. We've already got it hooked up. Home, Android Auto. Very easy. Comes right up. You can see we've got Waze up right now. Click here. You've got YouTube Music. And then your home screen. Let's go down to settings. I do like how it's sort of built into the rest of the screen. You still have kind of this Volkswagen home screen over here. You can still do heated seats. And still come home real quickly, get your notifications. All right, Apple CarPlay. And here we are, Apple CarPlay, and a nice little animation. There's your main screen there. Got music, very high resolution, looks good, response rate is nice. And your settings screen. All right, let's get out on the road. We'll be right back. strange to get in a system like this, but I've noticed that it's happening more and more often with Harman Kardon systems. The speakers are there. You've got tweeters, you've got a subwoofer, you've got a center speaker, but they tune it with this strange mid-range hollowness that it sounds so corny. It doesn't sound good. It creates an echoiness to the music and just makes it overall harsh on the ears, especially when you turn it up a lot. Kind of hear, especially in that chill shop, but still hear this one too. It's almost as if we have a fake surround sound that I keep setting on, but I've got it set all the way to stereo, surround off. To give you an idea of what I'm talking about, I'm going to switch on my preferred equalizer settings, and you can see how dramatically I take down the upper mid-range, and see what you think for yourself about how that sounds. Maybe to you it won't sound better, but I think it sounds much more natural and crisp. We'll be right back. 9-speaker system here in the Golf GTI, the 2022 Mark 8 model. It's a tough system to evaluate because there's so much going on here. You've got this brand new infotainment system for Volkswagen where they're trying really hard and doing well at some things, not well at other things. You've got the frustrating haptic controls that don't feel intuitive, and you got to slide around. If your finger's sweaty, that doesn't work super well. Then you've got these good speakers and a subwoofer back there that, when tuned right, sound pretty good, and they have a decent amount of power, but it takes some dialing in, and I appreciate that there is that 5-band equalizer, but, like, why is the subwoofer setting all the way to the right? There were multiple times where I went to adjust my treble and realized I was adjusting the subwoofer. Maybe you'd get used to that, maybe once you kind of set it as an owner, you'd sort of forget about it, but all of that is to say, I'm landing on a C for this system. It was really close to a B. I was giving it a B there for a while, but I can't get behind it. There's too much weirdness. Maybe, I guess, if you owned it for a while, you got comfortable with using it all, and you dialed in your sound settings right, this could definitely be a B-tier system. But there's just such weird mixing from Harman Kardon on the mid-ranges on there that it's got to be a C. So thank you all so much for watching. If you want to see more on the Mark 8 GTI, we've got our highway fuel economy test, where it's getting in 39 according to the dash right now, and our driving review. And we'll see you on the next one. I'm Charlie from Daily Motor, and as always, drive on. No knob. No tuner buttons, F tier.